After playing through this truly epic adventure, I wanted to take the time to go back and discuss and analyze the ending because I've thought about it a bit and I'm a bit unsure as to what just happened. If you haven't yet played through Castlevania Lords of Shadow, or if you're playing through it and haven't yet finished, I'd recommend not watching this video yet as it's going to be spoilerific. Now, all throughout the game we hear of Gabriel either turning evil, fighting off his evil thoughts, or just other vague foreshadowing of what's to come. Recall, when he first meets Pan and completes the puzzle before being granted access to the Lake of Oblivion, Gabriel is granted a vision of himself murdering Marie, and we see him with the mask that we eventually see Zobek wearing in the end. Later, Claudia foresees her own death at Gabriel's demise, and yet, she helps him anyway. Is this because she knows that he will construct the God's mask and ascend to heaven himself? Then we run into Carmilla, who states, "Death is merely a question of perspective. You will be one of us eventually." Is she implying that he will in fact become a Lord of Shadow himself? And the fact that he's willing to destroy the founders of his own order the whole time, does he subconsciously really want to destroy them? Then there's the issue of Zobek controlling Gabriel from the start and forcing him to kill his wife while wearing the evil mask. What is that evil mask? Why does Gabriel not mention that he can't remember the details about his wife's death anyway? Now, when we see Satan arrive and kill Zobek, or so we thought, as the ending after the credits shows Zobek very much alive, what really happened in the ending of the game? We see Gabriel holding Satan. It looks like they're both ascending to heaven. Then we see evil wings sprout from Gabriel's back. Is this Gabriel's spirit ascending to heaven and his dark former self remaining on the earth as the new Lord of Shadow? Is he actually Dracula? Look at the ending after the credits. He actually calls himself Dracul. So what's the deal? Was Gabriel Dracula the whole time? Is he Dracula at all? Was it his shadow that was left over as the new Lord of Shadow and his light form ascended to heaven like the other Lords of Light and Shadow? How is Zobek still alive? Granted, he is death himself. Does Satan just not have the ability to kill death? The way the ending was presented really left a lot of this open to interpretation. Not to mention the fact that the second ending takes place nearly 1,000 years in the future. What happened between then? Was that where the other Castlevanias take place and the other Belmonts are actually fighting Gabriel as Dracula? Is there going to be a modern sequel that takes place where the second ending left off? So many unanswered questions. What do you think? I'd love to see some video responses. Otherwise, leave your thoughts, interpretations, questions, and comments below. Check out the full write-up and screenshots over at ZeitgeistGameReview.com. Stay up to date by following me on Twitter and Facebook, and make sure to check out all of the other great gaming entertainment on the GameStation. Don't forget to subscribe and press the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching.